In this session, let us solve a numerical problem on the load flow analysis using Gauss Seidel method. The Gauss Seidel method is an iterative method. These iterative methods are used to solve nonlinear equations. In the iterative methods, after each iteration, we get closer to the actual solution by one step. So, the more the number of iterations, the more the accuracy of our solution. Usually, we are using digital computers to perform these iterative methods. So, we can conduct some 100 number of iterations or some 250 number of iterations in order to get the better accuracy. In this problem, we have to do only one number of iterations. At the end of the first iteration, we need to find out the three bus voltages, V1, V2 and V3. In the power system, we have three types of buses. The first one is slack bus or the reference bus. The second one is PV bus or the generator bus. The third one is PQ bus or the load bus. There are mainly four parameters which we deal with in the case of load flow analysis. Magnitude of the bus voltage, the angle of the bus voltage, active power and reactive power. Out of the four parameters, two parameters will be specified at each bus. The remaining two parameters we have to find out. In the case of slack bus, both the magnitude and angle of the bus voltage will be specified. So we have to find out P and Q. In the case of PV bus, P and V are specified. So we have to find out delta and Q. In the case of PQ bus, P and Q are specified. So we have to find out V and delta. In this problem, the first bus is a slack bus. So both the magnitude and angle of the bus voltage is specified. The second bus is a PV bus. So P is specified, the magnitude of bus voltage is also given. The third bus is a PQ bus. So P and Q are given in the question. We need to find out the three bus voltages V1, V2 and V3 at the end of the first iteration. But V1 is already given in the question. So whether it is the first iteration or the 100th iteration, this bus voltage will not change. So this V1 will remain the same. When it comes to the second bus, the magnitude is given in the question. The magnitude of bus voltage is given. So this will not change. So we have to find out only the angle of the second bus voltage. And in the case of third bus, this is a PQ bus. So we have to find out both magnitude and the angle of the bus voltage in the third bus. Now let us first find out the bus admittance matrix of this power system. Here the line impedances are given. Let us find out the line admittances first. Y12 equals admittance equals 1 by impedance, 1 by Z12. This is equal to 1 by J0.4. This is equal to minus J2.5 per unit. Y13 equals 1 by Z13. This is 1 by J0.3. This is equal to minus J3.33 per unit. What is Y23? It is 1 by Z23. This is equal to 1 by J0.2, which is equal to minus J5 per unit. Let me mark the admittance values here. y12 equals minus j2.5. y13 equals minus j3.33 per unit, and y23 equals minus j5 per unit. All are in per units. Now let us find out the bus admittance matrix. This is a 3 bus system, so we will get a 3 cross 3 matrix. These are the elements y11, y12, y13. The second row is y21, y22, y23. The third row is y31, y32. And y33. This is equal to, what is y11? The total admittance connected to the first bus. This is how we find out the diagonal elements, the total admittance connected to that particular bus. Here it is minus j2.5 plus minus j3.33. So this is minus j 5.83. What is y12? This is the negative of the admittance connected between the bus number 1 and the bus number 2. It is minus of minus j 2.5. this is j 2.5. this is how we find out the off diagonal elements, and y21 is same as y12. So this is also j 2.5. what is y13? Negative of the admittance connected between bus number 1 and bus number 3. So this is minus of minus j 3.33. so this is j 3.33. and y13 is same as y31. So this is also j 3.33. What is y22? The total admittance connected to the second bus. This is minus j5 plus minus j2.5. this is minus j7.5. what is y23? The negative of the admittance connected between the bus number 2 and bus number 3. This is minus of minus j5. So this is j5. y32 is same as y23. So this is also equal to j5. Now what is y33? The total admittance connected to the third bus. Minus j5 plus minus j3.33. So this is minus j 8.33. this is our bus admittance matrix. Now let me write the given parameters of this problem. V1, V2, V3. In the iterative methods, we start with a guess or we start with an assumption if the initial values are not given. Let me mark the initial values as 0th iteration. These are the initial values here. Later we will do the first iteration. These are the three bus voltages. As it is the initial value or the 0th iteration, let me mark this as V10, V20, and V30. The superscript 0 represents the number of the iteration. And this subscript represents the number of the bus. So V30 is the third bus voltage in the 0th iteration. V10 equals, this is a slack bus. So both magnitude and angle are given in the question. So it is 1.05 angle 0. Or we can write this as 1.05 plus J0. What is V20? Only the magnitude is given in the question because this is a PV bus. The angle is not given in the question. So we need to guess a value or we need to assume a value. This is 0. This is an assumed value. Or we can write this as 1 plus J0. The magnitude is given in the question. Here both magnitude and angle are given in the question. If this is not given, if the voltage is not given in the question, we have to assume a value. Usually we assume 1 plus J0 if this is not given, or 1 angle 0, both are same. Then we will modify this voltage in each iteration. So the first iteration values are better than this 0th iteration values. And the second iteration values will be better than the first iteration value. This is what we are doing in the iterative method. After each iteration, we get closer to the actual solution. Now, P2 is also given in the question because this is a PV bus. Second one is a PV bus. P2 is equal to the next power at the second bus equals the generated power minus the load power. The generation is 3. There is no load power at the second bus. So this is 3 per unit. So this is 3 per unit. All are per unit values. What is P3? This is PG3 minus PL3. The next power at the third bus. The generation is 0 minus the load power is 4. So this is minus 4 per unit. So P3 equals minus 4 per unit. What is Q3? It is QG3 minus QL3. The generation minus the load. There is no generation here. Minus 2. So this is minus 2 per unit. Minus 2 per unit. These are the given parameters or our assumptions. Now let us move on to the first iteration. In the first iteration, we have to find out the three voltages. V1, V2 and V3. This is what we have to find out. But V11 will be same as V10 because this is a slack bus. For the slack bus, both magnitude and angle are given. 1.05 angle 0 or 1.05 plus J0. This will never change. And V21 equals the magnitude is given in the question because this is a PV bus. V is given. And this angle you have to find out. And in the third bus we have to find out both magnitude and angle. In order to find out this angle delta, first of all, we will find out a temporary voltage V2. From that, we will take only the angle delta because the magnitude is already given in the question. Now, in order to find out a temporary voltage V2, we should know what is P2, what is Q2. Both P and Q we should know. P is given, but Q we have to find out. The reactive power we have to calculate. This is the formula we are using. Q2 is equal to minus imaginary part of V2, it is V2 conjugate into Y21 V1 plus Y22 V2 plus Y23 V3. We are finding out the reactive power of the second bus, so we consider the entire second row. This Y21 V1, Y22 V2, Y23 V3. So all the terms are written here. Actually, this is the net current injected at the second bus. This is V2 conjugate. What is V2 conjugate into I2? This is P2 minus JQ2. We have to find out only the reactive power, the negative of the imaginary part. That's why it is written minus imaginary part of this bus. Now let us substitute the values. Now when you substitute the bus voltages, you have to substitute the updated voltage. For a particular bus, if the voltage is available in the first iteration, you should consider that. Then you should not go to the zeroth iteration value, because the first iteration values are better than the zeroth iteration value. Here in the first bus, the first iteration value is already available with us. So you should take V11. You should not take V10. But what about the second bus voltage? V21 is not with us. We are yet to find out the voltage V21. But V20 is available with us. So V20 you should write here. What about V3? V31 we have not yet calculated. We are going to find out the value. Only V30 is available with us. So I write V30. So you should take the updated voltage, the latest bus voltage available with us. So this is minus imaginary part of, what is V20 conjugate? V20 is 1 plus J0. The conjugate is 1 minus J0 into Y21 is J2.5 into V11. This is 1.05 plus J0 plus Y22. It is minus J7.5 into V30. It is 1 plus J0 plus Y23. This is J5 into V30. It is 1 plus J0. Now this is equal to minus imaginary part of, this is J2.625 minus J7.5 plus J5, and this is equal to minus imaginary part of 0.125, and this is equal to minus, the imaginary part is 0.125 per unit. So this is our Q2. Let me mark the value Q2 here. Now Q2 is equal to minus 0.125 per unit. Now let us find out the second bus voltage V2. Where do we find out the second bus voltage? Because we need to get the value delta. So V2 is equal to 1 by Y22 into P2 minus JQ2 divided by V2 conjugate minus Y21 V1 minus Y23 V3. Here we do not consider the diagonal element. this is not considered here. We have taken only Y21 V1 and Y23 V3. Actually, this is the net current injected at the second bus. These are the currents flowing from the second bus to the first and the second to the third bus. These are the outgoing currents. These are the net current. This is the net current injected at the second bus. Now, here also you should substitute the latest bus voltage available. So, for V1, the first iteration voltage is there. So, V1 should be taken. When V1 is available with us, why should you go for V10? Because this is the better voltage. Now, V20 is there. V21 we have not yet found out. The delta is not with us. So, this is V20. For V3 also, only the initial values with us, or the zeroth iteration voltage is with us. Now, let us substitute the values. 1 by Y22 equals minus J7.5 into what is P2 minus JQ2? P2 is 3 minus JQ2. Q2 equals minus 0.125. So, it becomes 3 plus J0.125. Divided by V20 conjugate. So, it becomes 1 minus J0 minus Y21 V1. What is Y21? J2.5 into what is V11? 1.05 plus J0. Minus Y23 into V30. This is Y23. V30 is 1 plus J0. And this is equal to 1 by minus J7.5 into 3 plus J0.125 divided by 1 minus J0 minus J2.625 minus J5, and this is equal to 1 by minus J7.5 into 3 minus J7.5, and this is equal to 1 plus J0.4, or this is equal to 1.077 angle 21.8 degrees. Here we should consider only this angle delta. This magnitude cannot be taken because the second bus is a PV bus, so the magnitude is already given in the question. So, we should take only this angle 21.8 degrees. So, this is 21.8 degrees per unit. And in the rectangular form, this is equal to 0.9285 plus J 0.37137. Now let us find out V3. V3 equals 1 by Y33 into P3 minus JQ3 divided by V3 conjugate minus Y31V1 minus Y32V2. When you find out the third bus voltage, you should not consider this diagonal element here. We consider only Y31V1 and Y32V2. And this is equal to, so here also you should substitute the updated bus voltages. V1 is there, so you should take V11, not V10, because the first iteration values are better than the zeroth iteration values. So when V11 is there, you take that value. What about V2? V21 is already calculated. So V21 is there with us. So where should you go for V20? Because the better voltage is there with us. So this is V21. What about V3? V31 is not with us. We have not yet calculated this value. So you choose V30. Now let us substitute the values. 1 by Y33. This is Y33. Minus J 8.33 into P3 minus JQ3. P3 equals minus 4 minus JQ3 equals minus 2. So it becomes plus J2. It is minus 4 plus J2 divided by V3 conjugate. V30 conjugate. V30 is 1 plus J0. So this is 1 minus J0. Minus Y31V1. This is Y31. J3.33 into V11. It is 1.05 plus J0. Minus Y32. This is Y32. J5 into V21. It is 0.9285 plus J0.37137. So this is equal to 1 by minus J8.33 into minus 4 plus J2 minus J3.49965 plus, so this term equals 1.85685 minus J 4.64245, and this is equal to 1 by minus J 8.33 into minus 2.143 minus J 6.14, and this is equal to 0.73704 minus J 0.25724. In the polar form, this is equal to 0.78064 angle minus 19.24. This is our V3. So V3 equals 0.78064 angle minus 19.24 degree per unit. So these are the three bus voltages at the end of the first iteration.